So what are your expectations for post-2015, and what is your organization planning to be, how to be part of the process?
Our expectations for the 2015 is for total participation of civil society organizations in the post-2015 agenda. Because you remember when we held the Millennium Development Goals, most of the organizations were left out of this process. They didn't input into the main agenda of the Millennium Development Goals. As we go ahead, we are now quite aware that if we are left out as organizations, there will be nothing for us without us. So it's high time we start, already we have started preparing for ourselves for the 2015 coming to an end of the MDGs. As we get into the SDGs, the Sustainable Development Goals, it's our voice that should be heard, because we don't have to be caught unawares by most of the governments. Because when they decide these things, it's for them, for them to benefit, and leaving out the ordinary person whom we are working with, and most of the people are left out of these processes and they don't benefit from it. It remains a preserve of the of those who are either in government, who are well connected, yet the civil society organizations are on the ground already doing work, working with people, working with the poor, the marginalized, and the issues of aid is something that really needs to be monitored, and we should know who is doing what, who is taking what, is it benefiting us? Do we really need, as Africa, to continue getting aid? Yet we've got so many mineral resources, we've got so many things at our disposal as Africa, but we remain the poorest continent in the whole world, because as much as we have the resources, but we have access to it, do we control the resources? We don't have that. So we are saying we are already on the ground trying to conscientize the communities and everyone else, especially the women, when we are looking at goal number 10 of the SDGs, that speaks of equality. Do we have that? Is it happening? What is it? We are looking at issues of water, sanitation, hygiene. What is it? Are we hands-on with the people, with the communities? So these are some of the things that we are expecting. And from an organization perspective, the organization that I'm representing today is Zimbabwe Coalition on Data and Development. We are looking at how much debt we have. Is that debt, do we really own that debt? Or it's just a continuation of debt and not coming to an end? What do we have in place? We have been advocating, we've been lobbying with the ministries of finance, but they still want to go to IMF and borrow. But we are saying, as much as you would want to borrow, is it benefiting the ordinary person? Because we know World Bank and IMF, they put so many conditions for you to get, and the interest is just so much. We cannot continue borrowing. The governments cannot continue borrowing. So we are saying, let's talk about debt cancellation. Because as long as we have this debt, we remain poor. We remain with nothing, and in the end, women and children, they continue to suffer, and men, we are not saying men who won't suffer the same, because they have to go to work, they have to continue working for the families, and this promotes violence within a family setup. So we are saying issues of debt, they should come to an end.